Order. The question is that this bill be now read a second time, and the member for Dawson has the call.
Well, thank you, Madam Deputy Speaker, and I rise to speak on the Sugar Research and Development Services Bill 2013, the Sugar Research and Development Services Consequential Amendments and Transitional Provisions Bill 2013, and the Sugar Research and Development Services Consequential Amendments Excise Bill 2013. And these bills seek to consolidate the research and development processes of the Australian sugar industry. These bills do wind up Sugar Research and Development Corporation and also BSES Limited, and the assets of both those organisations and their research and development functions are going to be transferred to the industry-owned Sugar Research Australia. That is a single research and development body that will deliver greater efficiencies and better outcomes for the sugar industry, both growers and millers. Now, as it stands in the sugar industry today, we have a number of smaller organisations conducting research for the sugar industry, and that means there's a lot of duplication in those processes. The duplication of administration alone is a vast waste of resources. By the time these smaller organisations have been set up and are fully operational, much of their funding is exhausted. This single R&D body, an industry-owned research and development company, will be funded by a statutory levy of 70 cents per tonne of sugarcane processed or sold for processing. Now, the levy will be paid equally by the grower and the miller, and under current arrangements, R&D bodies are funded through a statutory levy of 14 cents per tonne and a number of voluntary contributions, including 55 cents per tonne for the BSES and an estimated 5 cents per tonne for the research elements of Sugar Research Limited activities. I note, though, that in some of those voluntary contributions, like all voluntary payments, some of them don't happen. So obviously it throws those organisations and the good work they do into jeopardy when they're unsure about the financial investment they're going to get. Now, these bills put into action a proposal contained in a report conducted by the Australian sugar industry. For more than 2 years, the report gathered more than 100 written submissions. And to get that report together, they held more than 200 meetings right across the industry, including a public roadshow early last year that saw 1,000 growers actually turn up and have a look at this proposal. Now, the resulting proposal aims to modernise the industry with a strong organisation, the Sugar Research Australia, which will be able to attract and retain the best researchers and staff while also raising investment in cane farming. Now, the single research organisation will bring together the activities of the three current sugar industry organisations, that is the BSES, the government industry entity called Sugar Research and Development Corporation, and aspects of the sugar milling research agency, Sugar Research Limited. The single entity, Sugar Research Australia, can balance the need for a secure funding base and the need for a reasonable and affordable levy to be imposed on the industry. As a result, more money will be available for research, and that's the key thing here. It'll be more money available for research, more money available for different varieties, more money for biosecurity, because overheads will be reduced. Now, industry stakeholders, who will be the owners of Sugar Research Australia, will see their funds further leveraged, with the Australian government actually matching funding for R&D every year at 0.5% of the gross value of production. And that's a very welcome initiative from the government. Now, Madam Deputy Speaker, this proposal and these bills come before us after this extensive consultation with the industry, and as a result, the bills actually have extensive industry support. I am aware, though, that there are some concerns about the legislation from some sectors of the industry, notably the Australian Cane Farmers Association. And also, while I think there is generally support and a high level of support throughout my electorate, there are some organisations with concerns, not enough to say they don't want this to go ahead, but just some concerns about how Sugar Research Australia will actually operate. One of those concerns is that one-on-one extension will be abandoned. And the reality, though, is that the extension process, which allows that one-on-one service to individual cane growers and in North Queensland, is actually occurring outside of the current R&D framework, as it will carry on outside the new R&D framework. What has happened is that growers have got together and have established their own networks of extension services, such as in the Mackay area, the Mackay Area Productivity Service, and there's various different extension providers that are mainly organic. There's been this organic network of these extension services that have popped up to fill the gap that the BSES once was involved in and has gradually pulled away from as their resources have dwindled. Now, there is nothing in this legislation that will actually prevent that organic, grower-controlled and local extension network from actually continuing on. Now, the proposal to move towards a single body actually acknowledges the need to maintain and even enhance, I suppose, that extension network, and I'm sure there will be linkages between Sugar Research Australia and these local extension offices. Now, I've received a letter from the Australian Sugar Industry Alliance, which outlines their view on the benefits of the move towards a single R&D body for the industry, and the Sugar Industry Alliance outlined four main elements to the reforms, including a transition program to strengthen the skill set of the network of local sugar extension providers to provide one-on-one advice to cane producers. So I am reasonably certain that the issue of extension is sorted out and will be sorted out by Sugar Research Australia, and there won't be a problem in the industry with that. Now, the other concern that I thought was of note, and it was certainly raised by the Australian Cane Farmers Association, is that there are a range of different grower organisations that actually fall outside the umbrella of cane growers, the peak body or the Australian Sugar Alliance, and that doesn't just apply to the Australian Cane Farmers Association. As I said, there's smaller independent organisations within my own electorate, Pioneer Cane Growers, Calamia Cane Growers, recently Invicta Cane Growers, so a number of different organisations that feel that they could be left out of discussions and consultation with the new body. So I do share that concern, but I see from the legislation, and particularly from the proposed constitution of Sugar Research Australia, that that body will be compelled to consult with all stakeholders, not just the Australian Sugar Alliance, although that will be one of the main consultative bodies they approach. Now, as the representative for Australia's largest sugar growing region, I will be ensuring through the different functions I have, and I'm a member of the House Standing Committee on Agriculture, if I'm here after September 14, that Sugar Research Australia actually does consult with all groups, especially those smaller groups, and including the Australian Cane Farmers Association. And I note the Shadow Agriculture Minister has said that he also sees that as a legitimate concern, but he believes that it can be actually dealt with in the funding arrangements between the Commonwealth and Sugar Research Australia, and I would probably impress that upon the Parliamentary Secretary, who's present as well, to ensure that that consultation is right across the industry when they're doing the funding arrangements with the Sugar Research Australia. Now, the Liberal National Coalition has conducted extensive consultation with industry to establish a firm position on this proposal, and that's because we act in the best interests of the industry, the individuals in the industry and all of the stakeholders in the industry, and that high level of consultation will continue. Now, Madam Deputy Speaker, through that extensive consultation from us, it's become quite evident that these bills have widespread support within the industry. Cane Growers CEO Steve Greenwood, in supporting the move to a single R&D body, said this: "Growers in the industry have had its say, and it's clear that there's very strong support for the proposed new body, Sugar Research Australia. A robust, stable and well-funded research and development system is essential to the Australian sugar industry's competitiveness on the global stage. Likewise, the BSES has supported the move with a reassurance that the best outcome for the industry and for the BSES will be the migration to a single body." Their chairman, Paul Wright, said in July last year, "All BSES directors support these important changes. The industry is working together to establish Sugar Research Australia, backed by a stable statutory levy at reasonable levels for growers and millers in order to sustain vital research. This is the best direction for the industry, and for the transition of BSES, the company, its research activities, and its 145 staff and associated casual workforce. Now, there was a sugar poll, and that were comments that were that Mr. Wright made in association with the sugar poll. It was an industry-wide poll that was administered by the Australian Electoral Commission in August last year. Now, of the 76% of the industry that actually voted in that poll, 84% voted yes in favour of creating Sugar Research Australia, that model as proposed by the Australian Sugar Industry Alliance. Now, prior to the start of voting in the sugar poll, a collection of industry leaders actually submitted messages of support for the yes case, and I note that Mackay Grower and then local cane growers chairman and a vice chairman of the cane growers organisation, Paul Scambury, who most recently has been elected the new chairman of Queensland Cane Growers, said we must take this opportunity for change, and that is how growers are seeing it. Mackay Grower and the new Mackay Cane Growers chairman, Lawrence Pajaya, said one new industry company with a compulsory levy will be efficient. You won't be subsidising non-payers, and that's an important point. Kevin Borg, actually, I've got that wrong. Lawrence Pajaya is the vice-chairman of Mackay Cane Growers. Kevin Borg is the chairman, Plain Creek grower in your electorate, Madam Deputy Speaker. He said, I'm voting yes to form Sugar Research Australia as a high-performance, energised industry-owned company with secure funding. Now, Mr Borg, in his new role as the Mackay Cane Growers chairman, wrote to me outlining the support that cane growers had for these bills and also a preferred timetable for the bills to be passed. And in his letter, Mr Borg said, industry has prepared all the ground for start-up and a new board of directors to be in a position to commence the vital work once the legislation has been passed through both Houses of Parliament. He went on to say, we're hopeful that legislation can be introduced and passed in the House by 6th of June. We're hopeful the legislation can be introduced and passed in the Senate in the period from 17th of June to the 27th of June. So Mr Borg and others in the industry have voiced their concerns about the urgency of the legislation. They wanted the bill to come before this place for a long time, and knowing the government will soon go into caretaker mode and Parliament will cease within a week, the industry has become anxious about the bill's speedy passage through the Parliament. It's vitally important these bills are voted upon and go through the Senate before rising. It is a bit of a shame the bills have been left until the last minute to be brought before the House, and I think it probably should have been something, given that there's support from both sides of the chamber, something that should have been done a while ago. If it's not done by the end of this parliamentary sitting, there is going to be a lot of sugar research and development staff left in limbo, and I know there's people in the Mackay BSES that are desperately worried because the BSES is dying financially. It simply doesn't have enough funding to keep going. Talented staff with experience and expertise and much to offer the industry feel there's no future for them or for staff of other smaller organisations. So some of the best and the brightest minds we have within the sugar industry are right now weighing up options because they don't have certainty. So we in this place must now act, and act now in the interests of the sugar industry. I believe the bills have a broad support in this place, and I urge the government to grant swift passage of this legislation to give those best and brightest research minds the certainty they had. And since I'm the last speaker on this, I think, other than the Parliamentary Secretary summing up, I suggest that it might be a good time frame for the Parliamentary Secretary to perhaps put to the Manager of Government Business that we get this voted on this week, and I hope that can happen with the day left of the sitting. Now, without the certainty and without the prospect of a stable funding foundation for the industry collected under one roof, you'll find that many of those R&D people will vote with their feet if this is left until after the election. They will move overseas, they will take up research jobs with our competitor countries, and that'll be a serious blow for the industry. So if this is not passed and passed expediently, the sugar industry will lose those key people overseas, which will place Australian exporters at a disadvantage and which will create an advantage for our competitors. So I do urge the Parliamentary Secretary to impress upon his government colleagues to get this voted on as soon as possible in this place.
The question is that this bill be now read a second time. I call the Parliamentary Secretary.
Thanks very much. And I do thank the members for Collier, Hinkle and Dawson for their support of the local and national sugar industry certainly take on board the viewpoints that they've represented, particularly the member for Dawson, so very well. I note that the member for Clare, an opposition spokesperson for agriculture, did note the comment from the Mackay sugar mill owner that said it's absolutely essential we pass the legislation. The member for Dawson's reinforced that. The government is certainly reinforcing that. And we do take on board the comments made by the member for Clare and also the member for Dawson about the need for genuine consultation, the need for particularly taking into account priorities in the funding agreement and the priority setting processes. So we take that on board, and we certainly hope the new authority takes it on board as well. So thanks for your contribution and your positive response to this.